So, Boker Tov, Kal Kadosh, Shavua Tov, we're going to continue with Kuf Yud Daled Amud Aleph, which is 114a. We were right by the concept of that the same clothing that a person uses to cook for their master, they should not serve their master. And we brought it by the Kohen Gadol that he always used to switch his clothing on Yom Kippur. So now we're a few lines down, two, four, five lines down where it says, Amen Ruchia Barabba, Amen Yochanan, says Ruchia Barabba, Amen Yochanan. It's a disgrace for Tamil Chacham to go out with the shoes that have patches to the marketplace. Okay? So ask the Gemara, what? Did you go out like this? So answers the Gemara, Amar Vacha Bered Rahman, says Vacha Bered Rahman, it's lie, it's lie. No. We're talking about that you have to fix it on top of a patch on top of another patch. Meaning one patch is okay. Once it becomes one patch on top of another patch, that's where it's disgraceful. Any Tamil Chacham that you find a stain, whether it's of fats or things like that in his clothing, is chayav mita. Why? Because a Tamil Chacham has to have his kavod of the Torah, and therefore, right, Shneimar says in Pasuk, kol misanei avu mavet, al tikre misanei lemesniyai, which means he causes people to hate the Torah because if he's not going to be properly dressed, so people will say, look at these people, they're all dirty, Tamil Chachamim, you know, this, that. So that's why you have to be very careful. Ravina says, Revad Itman. It wasn't written Revav, it was written Revad, okay? Which is Shichvat Zera. Right? He says, right? The Habliglima, Shichvat Zera is a semen. So he says, Habel Lima, Habel Vusha. One of them was talking about on the outer clothing, and one of them was talking about on the inner clothing, which means on the outer clothing was because it was going to become disgusting for people. And on the inner clothing was because of the Shechvat Zera. What does it mean in the Patsuk? That he went for 3 years without clothing and barefoot. So he says, Arom means the Gadim Bluim. It doesn't mean that he was mamash without clothing. It just means that he was with the Gadim Bluim, clothing which are Bluim, like they're, how do you say Bluim? They're like worn out. Yachef means not without shoes at all, but rather the Menalim and Tulaim, and it's got patches. Tanan Hatam, we learned over there in the Mishnah. Revav ala Mirdat, when a person has Revav, which is a Chelev and Shuman, like, you know, there's fats on his clothing, ala Mirdat, on top of the Mirdat of the Chamor, which basically is like a, they put it on the chamor as like a saddle, right? Chotzetz, it's a chatzitzan tevila. Because since people are usually makpid on the revav mimdat, so therefore it's a chatzitzan. It's going to be until an isara italki, that's what normally people are going to be makpid. But if it's going to be less than that, people are not makpid. But a begadim mitzad echad eno chotzetz, on one side of the clothing is a chatzitzan, right? But he says, Mishnah Tzadim, if it's going to be both sides, it's a chatzitzan. And Yehuda says in Yishmael, even on one side of the clothing, it's going to be chatzitza, because people are machidim, even if it's going to be dirty on one side. Babinir b'shimam l'akish v'alchanina. Ask b'shimam l'akish v'alchanina. Mirdat mitzad echad on Yishmael tzadim. And when we're talking about the mirdat, is that also from one side or both sides? Because we spoke about the clothing on one side or both sides. But what about the mirdat? Amalei, he says, Zulo Shamati, didn't hear this case exactly. But I did hear something similar to it. The Tanam was learned in Mishnah. Rabbi Yosef, Omer Rabbi Yosef says, "Shel banaim mitzad echad v'shel bur," right, which means banaim are people that builders. They right. It says over here they're makpidim, bekadim, bigdehem. Oh no, sorry. Banaim, it doesn't tell them what they are. Ah, the Gemara is going to explain it. Tamid chachamim, right? But it doesn't explain it at the beginning. It just says Banaim from one side of a bur, it's going to be two sides. Bur is like, you know, like a Malam Aretz. So the Midat is not better than a Begit of an Aretz. What are Banaim? I'm Rabbi Yochanan, says Rabbi Yochanan, Tamil Chachamim. Sheoskim Minyan Shalom. They're Tamil Chachamim, they're dealing with the Esek of the world. Right? They're dealing with the building of the world. Okay, because they're always building. Remember, Tamil Chachamim are builders. So that's still the Shiur that we gave last night, right? They're builders. Amen of Yochanan, says of Yochanan, Ezu Tamil Chacham Shemazinu Avida B'Tviyutayim. Who's the Tamil Chacham that you're allowed to return a lost object with Tviyutayim? Usually, with the I, it doesn't work. Meaning like this, let's say I lose something. So let's say I lost this book, but there's no siman. Or let's say I lost a certain mask, anything. There's no siman, there's no signs. So usually you need a sign. And you need a sign which is good. So I have to tell you, how did it look like? Ah, it had a tear over here, it had a scratch over there, it had a this, it had a that, it had a mark. You have to give a sign. Tefillin time just means a recognition of the eye. Usually it doesn't help, but for a Tamil Chacham, you can give it back even with the recognition of the eye. But who's the Tamil Chacham? The Makbid, it's somebody that's Makbid al Chalukol al Chuch. But he's always Makbid, that he will always put on his clothing in the right way, not backwards. Because if you put it on his clothing backwards, it's not good. Rabbi Yochanan says, who's the Tamil Chacham that they're going to put him on a Tzibur to become like, you know, Rabbi of a Tzibur, Manig of a Tzibur? He says they could ask him a question in any halacha, and he'll know it. He'll know how to answer. And even Masechet Kala, the people usually don't answer, he'll know how to answer it. Rabbi Yochanan says, who's the Tamil Chacham? That the people of the city are obligated to do his work, which means they are obligated to give him parnasa in order that he could learn. He says that he's leaving his things and he's doing only things of Shemaim. He's only working for HaKadosh Baruch Hu. He says this is only for his bare necessities, but not for more than that. Okay, meaning that his necessities, not for luxuries. Rabbi Yochanan says of Yochanan, who's a Tamil Chacham? Right, somebody that they ask him any halacha, and he says it. So he says, So he says, even if it's going to be only one mesechet, right? So then they're going to put him, the rabbi of a tzibur in his area. But if it's going to be in everything, so then they can make him like the Rosh Yeshiva, right? Because obviously he's a much higher level. Rav Shimon ben Akish says, who are the Banaim? They are not Talmidei Chachamim. Who is it? A different explanation. Elu Kelim al-Yarin Habayin Midat Hayam. These are the ones of the Balanim of the Bet HaMerchatz. Meaning, a Balanit is a woman that she takes care of the Mikveh. So Balanim, or we're talking about the utensils from the Merchatzahot, which they come from the Nat Hayam, from the diaspora. Okay, so we're talking about people from bathhouses. So obviously, if you go to a bathhouse, they have to make sure that their clothing are very clean. So ask the Gemara, Lememra Dechivre Ninu, are you going to tell me that these are white? Rabbi said to his children, but I and my children, don't bury him, not in Kelim Levanim or Kelim Shechorim. Says why? Levanim, Shema lo eske. He says in white, because maybe he's not going to be Zoche to Gan Eden. And since he's not going to be Zoche to Gan Eden, he's going to be Chatan between the Avelim. Meaning, imagine right now, he puts on white clothing, he goes up to Shemayim, and then what's going to happen? He's going to have to go to Geinam. Right? It's going to be crazy. He's going to say, what? He's going to be between all the people wearing black, and he's the only one wearing white. It sticks out. So he says, but not on black people, not on black clothing. The Shema is scared, because maybe he's going to be Zocher, the Yekeh ben HaChatanim. Because maybe he's going to be like an Avel between Chatanim. Maybe he's going to be Zocher to Gan Eden. And really, be met, he's going to be like, he's wearing black clothing. It's like, oh, well, what are you doing? You're having Avelut. So rather, the kelim of Yonam, rather like these clothing which are not black and not white, that come from Dinat Yam, Almay Sisi, soon can you know that it's like reddish. So answers the Gemara, Lakashia, again it's not a question. Habiglim Abdevushe. One of them is the outer clothing, one of them is in the inner clothing. Okay? Fine. Two dots. Okay, the Bishmael Omer Mekaplin. So Bishmael says you're allowed to fold clothing on Shabbat. Or to Kippur, or to Kippur on Shabbat. When it says Olat Shabbat Bishabbato, it teaches you that Chelve Shabbat are allowed to be brought on Shabbat, which is Yom Kippur. So too of Yom Kippur Bishabbat. No, Bishabbato. The extra, why didn't it say Olat Shabbat Bishabbat? Why did it say Olat Shabbat Bishabbato? The extra Vav tells you that not from Kippur to Shabbat. These are the words of Ishmael. Bekiva Omer Bekiva says, Olat Shabbat v'Shabbato, Yimelchev v'Shabbat v'Shabbatim Yom Tov, so that you are allowed to bring in Yom Tov. So I would have thought to say even in Yom Kippurim, Kamu Lomar b'Shabbato, Keshetinsal Omar, when you want to come and say, right, the Dever of Ishmael, according to Ishmael, the Dever of Kabim Yom Tov, that any neder in Milva is Bar Yom Tov. So when you need this pasuk, Yom Kippurim, the divrei Rabbi Akiva contra Rabbi Akiva, medavrim and nedvot and krivim Yom Tov. You don't bring a neder in Nedvan Yom Tov. Right? That we actually just spoke about that in the halachot this morning. That you don't bring a neder in Nedvan Yom Tov. So when do you need to permit it in Yom Tov? So Amar Rabbi Yezera says Rabbi Yezera, right? He comes and he says as follows. Right? He says, yeah, Amar Rabbi Yezera, we're in Kuf Yudal Adam Ubet. Ki Avina beBavel, when we were in Bavel, have Amar the East to say, I detain that we should run the Brighta. Yom Kippurim Shechal Yom Erev Shabbat. When Yom Kippur falls out on Shabbat, lo yu tokin, they wouldn't be tokea, right, the shofar. Because of the Kiddushah of Yom Kippur, Erev Shabbat, which is a sur, therefore you didn't need another one. That means you didn't need to make another, like, a tkiat shofar or whatever it is, you understand? So he says, so what happened then? So he says, lo yu mavdilin, they wouldn't do Avdalah, according to everybody. Kislik lanatam, when we got over there, Ashkechim Yehuda B'letim Shimon Pazidat Kamani was saying, Rabbi Akiva. So he says, according to Rabbi Akiva, he comes and he says, right, as follows. He says, right, Rabbi Akiva, he, dear Rabbi Shimon, but it's going to be like Rabbi Shmuel, came on the Amar, since he said, right, that's what he says over here, since he came and he said, 1 second. Fine. So it says over here like this. He said, according to Rikiva, he went and he said, the year of Shemuel is going to be Shemuel, given the man, since he said, right, Chelve Shabbat Kredim Yom Kippurim, the Chelve Shabbat are brought on Yom Kippurim, Litka, you should be Tokea, Ki Eched Elavi Yadeh, the Chelve Shabbat Kredim Yom Kippurim, to show you that Chelve Shabbat are brought on Yom Kippur. So they should have brought, done Tkiat Shofar. So Vamin Le'ana, but we said, no, Konim Zizimem, which means to do a Tkiat Shofar, they didn't want to permit it. To do with the Kohanim, since they're Bikinim and Halachot, they don't need a Heker to know the difference. Okay, Amar Emor Kashisha Ben Del Chassad Ravashi, says Emor Kashisha, by the son of the Chassad Ravashi, do we say Kohanim Zizimem? Atram Inot El Mishnah, Shalosh Lavtil Atam Melacha, we used to blow 3 times in order to stop them from doing Melacha. The Shalosh Lavtil, and 3 also to be Kavder Ben Kol Shechol. So it says the Gemara, no, it's like Kedamar Abaye, Abaye says, Yisharma di Yerushalayim to the other people in Yerushalayim, Achanam, so to hear. They used to do enough for the Kohanim. Kohanim was easy. They used to do the Tkiat Shofar and all of the things for other people, not for themselves. Okay? So now it says the Gemara, the Litka, they should do Tkiat Shofar. Just like you should know how to do with the Kivat Yerek, right, from the Yerushalayim, which means on Kippur in itself, they're allowed to come, they're allowed to start preparing vegetables or whatever to eat on Motzei Kippur, right, from the Mincha time onwards. Right, so it says over here, in order that I would be ready to prepare the Motzei Tzom. Okay, Tam Rav Yosef says of Yosef, no, the fish end of in Shul Ati, we're not going to push off a shoot to permit it. Rav Shisha Ben Davidi, a man, Rav Shisha Ben Davidi says, should provide tiru, only something which is very close to permitted, but not rechoka. So therefore, right, to do it like another year, they didn't want to do it, because another year it wouldn't come out, a kippur would fall out on Shabbat. So therefore, right, that's why it's completely different halachot. So says the Gemara, should provide tiru, the permitted shoot, which was actually very close, but Trani went on the Mishnah. Yom Tov Shechal Yot Erev Shabbat, when Yom Tov comes out on Erev Shabbat, Tokim, they used to do tiyat shofar, to stop people from, you know, doing things. A lot of them, they wouldn't do Abdallah on Friday night. The Motzei Shabbat, they do Abdallah on Motzei Shabbat. They're not talking, but they wouldn't do Tkiat Shofar. But why not? Litka, they should. In order that everyone should say that it's permitted to do Shechita immediately. But rather, Mechvarta could have said, but it's rather, to, again, we're going to go like Rav Yosef to permit, and not like Rashish Ber Deravidi, that he says. Amram Zera Amar Avuna, Vamila Amar Abiyabra Amar Avuna. Yom Kippurim that comes out on Shabbat, you're not allowed to do anything on Shabbat itself, to permit from it to Shabbat. Okay, but that means you're not allowed to in such a scenario. So Amar Rav Mana says, Tana, we learned, Inan Yom Kippurim Shechal Yom Shabbat Shasu B'Knivat Yerek, how do we know that if Kippur falls out on Shabbat, you're not allowed to do Knivat Yerek, you're not allowed to do all these vegetables. Tamu Lomar Shabbaton, what does it mean Shabbaton? Shevot, right, you have to do Shevot, which means you have to wait, Lemay, for what? If you're going to tell me it's from Melacha, we're talking about Knivat Yerek. That's what we're talking about. it's going to teach you. So Amar Rabbi Yechiya Bar Abba Yochanan says Rabbi Abba Yochanan, he says, yeah, as follows. So it says, Yom Kippurim Shechal Yot, right? B'Shabbat Mutar Kivat Yerek. Yom Kippurim comes out on Shabbat, you're allowed to do Kivat Yerek. Maybe they asked him the question, you know, Yom Kippurim Shechal Yot B'Shabbat Yerek Tzisur, Kivat Yerek, that means you're not allowed to prepare. Tamunumar Shabbaton Shevot, which means don't work. They're mine. If you're going to tell me Timelacha, it was already written, not Tasek Melacha. But rather, we're talking about Kivat Yerek, that you're not allowed to do as well. So says the Gemara, no. Le'olam la'melacha, really we're talking about melacha. La'avor aleha ba'aseh ve'lo ta'aseh. You're transgressing a positive commandment and a negative commandment. Because when it says lo ta'aseh melacha, it's a negative commandment. When it says shevot, shabbaton, it's a positive commandment. The Tanya Kavit said, Rabbi Yochanan, Yom Kippur Shechal Yom Shabbat, also when Yom Kippur falls out on Shabbat, one kuf tetvav und alef, mutar b'knivat yerek. It's permitted in knivat yerek. Okay, so mefatzin and gozin, they're allowed also to break the walnuts, and farkasim rimonim, or to cut open by the klipot of the pomegranates on Kippur, from the mincha malam bnei ugmat nefesh, to add on. Why? Because when we're fixing these things and you're not allowed to eat, it makes it worse for us. So therefore, it's permitted. Rabbi Yehuda mekane b'krava, he used to make like holes in kruv. The Rava garde kare, so the household of Rava would come and they would cut the ruim, right, which are like pumpkins. Since he saw that they would be makdimim beforehand, right, he says, it came a letter from Rabbi Yochanan that he was saying it's asur to do that until Mutzatani. And we just finished the Perek, Adran Lach Veluk Shanim. So this Bezat Hashem, we just finished also this article. So Bezat Hashem, we continue with the fourth volume, Bezat Hashem, tomorrow.
Chazak u Baruch. Thank you very much, Rav.
A pleasure. So